Yo, Derek.
Don't you think you should be there when she wakes up?
Police were there. I can't. I couldn't really get out of there without them asking me a million questions anyway. Oh, fuck. I can't fucking believe this happens. Do you think she's gonna tell the police?
Derek, I don't know.
Okay, it had to be a bad batch or something.
Or that you gave her some pretty hard stuff. Derek. Be done with this. I know you didn't mean for this to happen, but look what it's got you into. Please, just be done.
I gotta go.
Got this last night. Should make us a few racks. What the hell is your problem?
I'm just trying to lay low, man.
Look, I don't care what your deal is. You said you wanted in. Now you're in.
Derek, what's gotten into you lately?
I'm fine.
You should be very proud of yourself. You're at a great school. You've got a bright future with a business degree. It's a degree you can actually get a job with.
Yeah, I know.
What more could you ask for?
Where have you been?
I've been around.
You dropped me off at the hospital and then I barely hear from you?
Sorry, I was busy.
Okay. Do you even want to know why I passed out?
You took some pretty hard stuff.
Yeah, and it didn't mix well with my medication.
Medication.
I have anxiety. Like, not just worrying about things, but legit relentless panic attacks.
I didn't know.
Yeah, nobody does.
I'm sorry.
It's not your fault. I've just come to being okay with not being okay. It's just harder when no one's there.
Look, I want what's best for you. Being around me obviously isn't that.
Maybe you're right.
Derek, you're a cool dude, man. You know, I've been thinking about it. I think it'd be good for you to do some business with me.
What are you talking about?
You're holding $1,000 worth of product right there.
What is it? Good. I don't want this anymore.
Do you want to be a little bit more specific?
You know what I mean. One out.
Okay, come with me.
What are you doing?
Where is it? Who has a VCR in 2016?
What are you doing? Kim, stop.
You said you wanted to change.
No, no, no. I could have sold that first and then changed.
Derek, no more, okay?
So in conclusion, after the downfall of the Soviet Union in 1991, we see the 1990s a period of rapid expansionary globalization. And as you recall, the chapter on globalization is quite long, so I recommend starting that as soon as possible after class. And looking ahead to our next unit, we see after the Cold War, the United States becomes the world's only superpower. We have a whole new chapter next time on economic liberalization in Eastern Europe. Be sure to review this chapter very carefully, especially pages 71 through 150. Now for your homework, I would like you to write an essay on how Mikhail Gorbachev's policies resulted in the downfall of the Soviet Union and how the United States, as a non-active partner, facilitated it in many ways. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Bye, Derek.
Bye. There he is.
What
was that? Yo, tell me you got some of that freshman.
He totally did.
I don't. But do you want to get something to eat, like, with me?
With you?
Maybe, yeah. Like,
okay, sure.
You know, this place has a lot of sentimental value to me.
Really?
Mm-hmm. That booth over there? That's where I had my first kiss.
Who's that with?
We don't need to get into details.
No. You brought it up.
Okay. Promise me you won't judge.
No judgment, sir.
Jason.
Jason Young.
Hey, you said you wouldn't judge. Okay. I was 15. Give me a break.
That's fine. Your secret's safe.
Good.
Now this place has some value to me too. My dad took me here a couple days after my 11th birthday. We sat down and he goes, "Derek, get whatever you want." Money was real tight at the time, so I was thinking, it felt like something was off. It was really quiet, you know. So we ate and then he looks at me and he goes, "Derek, your mother and I love you very, very much." No. Starts crying. Things with your mom and I, they're not working out. And she's gonna go away for a little while. It's real weird when you get bad news like that. But
I didn't know what to say. And he got up and he hugged me and he goes, "I'm sorry." And he just kept saying it over and over. All I could really say back was, "It's okay, Dad." But it wasn't okay. Sorry.
No, I'm sorry. We didn't have to come here.
No, no, it's fine. It's just the past. It doesn't matter. It's just...
You know, let's get out of here. Yeah.
Six-cylinder? Okay, you don't have to break your speed record.
Derek.
What in the world you think you were doing, son?
Sorry about that, officer. She just, she gets away from me sometimes.
Yeah, right. License and registration, please.
Oh, sorry, that's my Eagle Scout pipe.
You pulling my chain, son?
Oh, there you go.
Eagle Scout, huh?
Yes, sir.
What troop?
113.
Well, that's quite a coincidence. My son just joined 113.
Really? Well, congrats to him. Is Mr. Edison still there?
Yeah, I believe so.
You do me a favor? Tell him Derek says hi.
Yeah, I'll do that. I'll tell you what. I'm going to let you go with a warning tonight. But let's keep it on the 80. You got it?
Thanks, officer.
Okay, Eagle Scout.
What did I tell you, man? Where's my product?
It's gone.
Then where's my money?
There is no money.
You think this is cute, man? When I lose, Derek, you lose. Take that, sell the whole bag, and give me all the profit. But you're gonna lose a lot more than a laptop.
Hey, how are you?
Good.
Hey, oh my God, what happened to your eye?
Look, it's nothing. It's just rugby practice.
Are you sure?
Yeah, it's fine.
Okay.
Hey, man, you got my stuff?
Derek.
Kim. It's just some unfinished business.
I thought we flushed your unfinished business.
Stop.
You promised me you were done. So I get you out of trouble and you convince me that you're going to stop and then you...
Kim! This is who I am. You can't change it. If you don't get that, then... Why don't you just go? Go! Yeah.